Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our first ever Super Smash Brothers Super Show Road to G1 Climax Stage 1. We are live in Jacksonville, Florida, and we hope you enjoy this first ever Road to G1 Climax. Ladies and gentlemen, we're kicking things off with our Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix president, Mike the Beast Hager, one of the greatest icons in video game wrestling history. Mike Hager was elected as the first president of Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix. Hager was first introduced before Arcade Mania in Los Angeles, California, our first ever Saturday Night Slam Masters. It was the good old times that Mike Hager used to be a great video game wrestling icon, just like Kenoku Man, another great icon wrestler. They used to be great video game wrestlers back then. Also in the anime, of course. I think Mike Hager was a cartoon before? Yeah, I know where that is. I think he was in the anime, but do I have seen him? I'm not sure. But here's Mike Hager with a microphone. Here comes his introduction for the G1 Climax Tournament. I hope so too, and I hope you enjoy this first ever Stage 1 of the G1 Climax Tournament live in Jacksonville, Florida. Jacksonville Memorial Arena, home of the Jacksonville Sharks of the Arena Football League. Good applause from the fans here in Jacksonville. Mike Hager leaves the ring, and ladies and gentlemen, we are beginning with our first match in a G1 Climax contest. El Noveno takes on Curtis Sanchez in our opening G1 Climax Stage 1 contest. Here we go. El Noveno from Mexico, a luchador who is also the owner of the AWAC, who is a friendly competition with UCCW. Here comes El Noveno. Our wrestling partner relationship with AWAC, El Noveno, starts his match. Last time he had a G1 Climax match, he won against Seth Rollins, which is one of his biggest rivals in his career. If you want to know who's his biggest rival for El Noveno, go check out AWAC. If you want to know, PM me if you want or whatever. El Noveno in the ring, ready to start his next G1 Climax contest, which is going to be Curtis Sanchez, the Gladius of Killer, one of the most successful wrestlers in UCCW, a two-time United States champion, and a current New Jersey Call Wrestling heavyweight champion. Congratulations, Curtis Sanchez. Speaking of Curtis Sanchez, here comes the Gladius of Killer, Curtis Sanchez, one of the longest reigning U.S. champion in UCCW history, two-time United States champion, and a current defending New Jersey Call Wrestling heavyweight champion. The Gladius Supreme from St. Louis, Missouri, a junior ROTC student from University of St. Louis. A great student he was, and now he's reciting to a wrestler because he wants to be a tough, muscular, and most energetic wrestler strength. It's a confidential strength of the mind of this man, Curtis Sanchez. He has a trick sleeve in this mic. He's known to be a dirty player, but he's no good trick sleeve behind his back. That's who Curtis Sanchez is. A very good trickster he is. You better be careful how dangerous he can be. He's like a snake attack. He's like a sliver in hell. He's a believable lord of insanity. He's the goddess of all wrestling. Because he loves wrestling. Curtis Sanchez. Any words can best describe about Curtis with a God's true words. Curtis Sanchez ready to take on El Noveno tonight here in Jacksonville, Florida. Looks like we're in the University of Jacksonville, whatever that is. I may not be mistaken. Curtis Sanchez versus El Noveno. Here he goes. 30 minutes are on the clock and the time starts to roll, and here we go. Our first match underway here in G1 Climax in Jacksonville, Florida. Curtis starts off with the first strike against El Noveno. Counter with a drop kick by El Noveno. Oh, what a hurricanrana! Incredible impact onto Curtis Sanchez. Drop kick onto the turnbuckle. El Noveno starts to taunt, bring us a luchador spirit here in Jacksonville. Of course, his full known is for Spanish and Latino population in Florida. Florida's one of the best states, but worst thing about Florida when it comes to worse weather. Yeah, it's worse in Florida. I am not kidding. Curtis is taking a big, huge opportunity against El Noveno. And look at him go. Take it down, El Noveno. Really good. Curtis Sanchez. Big impact. One minute has been set over here in a G1 Climax. Power slam onto El Noveno, and look at that taunt! As a gaudiest power insane goes to his head. But he has a great skills beneath his mind as a god. Oh, counter from the clothesline by El Noveno! Hurricanrana onto Curtis Sanchez. And now El Noveno. Oh! Onto the chest! What a kick! El Noveno picks up his leg and does a leg DDT. El Noveno onto the turnbuckle. What does he have in mind? Oh! Oh! That's gotta hurt. Homo misjudgment from Curtis. Now Curtis, now back onto El Noveno. Great wrestler he is, and one of the best matches I've seen so far from Curtis Sanchez as a United States champion. He successfully defended his title against a true Dojo student from GXT. A successful British bootcamp student, Yami Bakura, and that was in a GXT Night of Champions first ever one-night only. Man, oh man, standing corkscrew moonsault. Here's a pin and kick out by Curtis by one. If you want to see the best match from Curtis Sanchez, my option is go check out Curtis Sanchez versus Yami Bakura. First ever one-night only Night of Champions. From GXT. That was one hell of a match I seen from Curtis Sanchez as a defending champion. Yami Bakura might be the best wrestler in the future, who knows? Great student he was. Let's see how great he is in GXT, which is coming up soon, so be patient. And like Hakeem said, stay cool, people. Right, here's a submission hold by El Noveno and lets him go. Apparently lost half his energy, and the people are getting off to a good start here in Jacksonville in the first stage of the G1 Climax Tournament. And Curtis Sanchez starts to taunt at El Noveno to get up. Apparently he picks him up for some reason. And El Noveno! Here comes El Noveno! Fights back. Got him with a DDT! Wicked move by El Noveno. And something's gonna deliver, and Senton delivered onto Curtis! Curtis in trouble. Oh! Clothesline by Curtis! Curtis! Ready to... El Noveno! Oh, nope! Guess drop kick. Let's see what happens to Curtis Sanchez. El Noveno looks fired up. He looks in trouble. Got him! He's in trouble! Here he goes! He's in trouble, Curtis! El Noveno! Look at this! Oh! Countered by Curtis. A nice sleeves up to Curtis. Ammo Veno in trouble. He's going to get the gaudiest of stomps. The punishment hells onto Ammo Veno. The punishment. The gods of stomps. And now, he's ready to give him the ultimate punishment. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. The punt kick. You gotta be kidding me. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Oh, counter by Ammo Veno. Ammo Veno. Frankensteiner onto Curtis Sanchez. It's not going to let it get a CKO, or surprisingly, wow, a freaking punt kick. Uh-oh, Curtis. And he gets drop kicked just like how Curtis did to Ammo Veno. Both of them are getting drop kicks. Oh, Ammo Veno. Oh, what a move. That was amazing. He's going for the pin. One, two, and no. Kick out. Could have been it. It's how weird people end matches, like some weird things in UCW lately. And now Curtis! Well, some of them. Sometimes is usually. Not the worst part that can happen. Curtis and oh, CKO! Holy smokes! I think that's it! There's a pin! Curtis is finally gonna get a win! And you and you. No! He was almost to a three count! And a devastating backbreaker! The Gaudy is a backbreaker by Curtis Sanchez! Holy cow! Ammo Veno fights back! Can he do it? Oh, wait a minute! That one is a Hellraiser! A Hellraiser performed by Ammo Veno! Here's a cover! Can he do it? Oh, he got him! Ammo Veno gets 2 points! Wow! He beat Seth Rollins, and now he beat the two-time U.S. champion, Curtis Sanchez. And that's not all. He was a current defending New Jersey Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. Oh, that's a big major changer here in the G1 Climax. Oh, other best way to turn around is a big reputation turnaround. Here's that finishing move. This right here, my friend, is Hellraiser. And here's that cover. One, two, and that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Ammo Veno is your winner, and he gets 2 points, and he remains undefeated so far in his career in UCCW. Excuse me. What a big start for Ammo Veno's first career in UCCW. He has never lost so far, and he's still undefeated in a G1 Climax tournament. Gracias, Señor Ammo Veno. What a great start that we're having so far here, video game wrestling fans, universe. And I hope you enjoy this opening G1 Climax Stage 1 of a Super Show, Road to G1 Climax. Next match, Wild Lobo versus Bowser is going to be an interesting match here in the Road to G1 Climax here in the Super Show. Now here comes Wild Lobo, the Knight of the Wolfhounds from the skies of beyond, the Wolf of Hound of Wrestler, Wild Lobo. And I hope he knows there's a new Wolf clan going on at GXT. Well, Brandon Wolf, Holo the Wise Wolf, there's two of them. I heard there's going to be a third one coming up soon. Spoiler alerts. I'm not going to say who it is. I bet you know who this guy is. He's from Call of Honors. He used to be friends with Brendan Wolf. Oh, I hope you noticed. Anyways, Wild Lobo is a great wrestler from WCCW and New Japan Call Wrestling. He used to be heavyweight, junior heavyweight champion New Japan. He used to be a WCCW heavyweight champion. And now, Wild Lobo, great wrestler so far. He's doing great in G1 Climax. But can he compete against this monster? 6-time hardcore champion, video game wrestling Grand Prix. Here comes a King Koopa, Bowser. Oh boy, this guy is dangerous. Poor Koopa, why do I say guy? Oh, God, that eyes. That burning flame. I hope this doesn't cause a smoke detector to go crazy in Jacksonville. You're in a Jacksonville Memorial Arena. Bowser is a 6-time hardcore champion, but he lost to Captain Falcon because of that interference that he got him pissed off in the Ultimate Survivor match, in the second one, after his Summer Smash. And that was in Tampa, Florida. Bowser lost to Captain Falcon in G1 Climax. And now his next contest is against Wild Lobo. Bowser's known to be a dangerous finisher as a bomb and a Koopa Chokeslam. Wild Lobo's finisher is known to be a Nightfall Powerbomb and a Frog Splash. Let's see how these two wrestlers go. The Wolfhound Wrestler, Wild Lobo, and a King Koopa, Bowser. And oh! Big start from Bowser. Here comes Bowser. And he's in knock. Bowser, big advantage against Wild Lobo. Oh! Look at this impact. Shoulder pain to Wild Lobo. And vicious knee onto his face of Wild Lobo. Now Wild Lobo, in trouble, gets a beating. He beat Curtis Sanchez in his first match, but he lost to Dominator in the next one. Can he regain top to defeat Bowser? And now Bowser picks up Wild Lobo against Eye-Rake by Wild Lobo. Insegurity performed by Wild Lobo. Wild Lobo fights back against King Koopa. And Wild Lobo is going to do something. Oh my god! That was a wicked move! You gotta love this high-flying technical wrestler! Great, great technical wrestler he is! Look at that! High-flying maneuver, great skills that Wild Lobo's doing right now! And gets countered by Bowser, and what a collision by Bowser! What a collision! Out of nowhere from the high-flying maneuver! He's one of the best high-flying maneuvers in CAW today! Wild Lobo! Doing great so far in G1 Climax after he defeated Curtis Sanchez. Then the next contest he lost to Dominator. Can he regain back? Has a winning record so far. Oh! Shades of Abyss! Also Jax from UCCW hits a pin. Two and no! Kick out by two. Wild Lobo back. Oh! Nice move by Wild Lobo. Wild Lobo got him. Oh, carrying that big Koopa with a backbreaker. Hope it doesn't hurt his knee because he has a pointy, sharp pins on this back. It's freaking shell. And now Bowser. Belly-to-belly suplex performed by Bowser. Bowser up to the turnbuckle. Oh, that's going to leave a mark. What a cheesy line that people use. That's going to leave a mark. It gets crazy, I know. And now, monkey flip! Onto this super heavyweight wrestler, Bowser. He's known to be a super heavyweight character. Now, boot Bowser. Boop, 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 Bowser. You need to be careful with everything. Now, Wild Lobo fights back and counter back and forth, back and forth. Look at this. Oh, spinning heel kick. Wild Lobo got him on hook. And Wild Lobo got him. Submission hold is big Koopa fee, and he got it. His big Koopa feet reached to the ropes, got it for the rope break, and now Wild Lobo pumped up, is all fired up, and here he goes. He's ready. Oh, uh-oh. Got him, watch out. Oh, missed a clothesline. Wild Lobo got him with another, no! Got him with a jackhammer. Another Shades of Abyss. How many people use that? 2-0 kick out. Just like Jax, how he used to do that. That was his signature move. Kind of reminds me of Abyss. Oh! Vicious backbreaker. It's one of those vicious moves. There's a cover. One, two, no! Wild Lobo kicks out. Wild Lobo back on top. Can he try his best? But the biggest question is, can he do a Nightfall Powerball on this super heavyweight character, Bowser? I hope he's better than Kevin Nash after what happened, this scary accident on the Big Show back in WCW in 1999. Yeah, I just went there. Scary, I know. And now Bowser. What's he out of mind, Bowser? Look at this. Oh! Wicked! Wicked, like Harry Potter. Going for the pin. Two and no! Kick out by two. Now, oh! Big punch by Bowser. Bowser continuing to stomp on Wild Lobo with his big, vicious Koopa feet. Yeah, look how big his Koopa feet is. It's obvious how vicious is King Koopa. Oh, nice drop kick by Wild Lobo. Wild Lobo. Oh, big move by Bowser. Made a counter. And then, oh, nice axe hammer onto Wild Lobo. Big vicious Koopa fist. Throws him back into the ring nicely. Bowser. Oh, watch out! Oh, that is a big crash and burn. Landed hard on his back. Pain for Wild Lobo. Oh, it could have gotten worse than that. And now Bowser. Look at the beating he's putting on Wild Lobo and reached a 25th minute length. No, it's 5 minutes length. Look at Wild Lobo's getting his destroyed, dismantled by King Koopa. Don't tell me, is he really going to do the same formula just like how he did to Captain Falcon? You know what I mean? After what he did to him on Summer Smash. That'll be crazy. A count. Oh! Are you supposed to stay in the ring if you want to win? We have reached a 9 count, and Bowser just managed to get inside the ring before a 10th count. Oh, Bowser's about to do a Bowser's Ba-Bomb. No! Counter by Wild Lobo. Uh-oh. This will be a scary... Oh, wait a minute. Not the way he wants to. He's going to do a frog splash. Can he do it? Oh! Got his knees up. Oh, boy. This might not end well. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, my God! Oh, look at that! Oh! Watch this one more time. Oh! That is Bowser's Ba-Bomb. A new way to do that. That's a new power bomb. Turn! Oh! So close! That was a close! Do you see how his hand reached to the floor? He almost got a 3 count. Bowser regained a point. 2 points, if I recall. Oh, scraped him in the face by his boots by Wild Lobo. Wild Lobo's not feeling good, is he going to focus? And he did! Wicked Hurricane Rana by Wild Lobo. Let's see. Is he going to do a Frog Splash again or do a Bowser's Ba-Bomb? Night Wolf Power Bomb? Nightfall Power Bomb, excuse me. Oh! Tilt-a-Whirl Slam against a giant! It could be possible. 1, 2, no! Kick out, spinning heel kick by Wild Lobo. This could be something. Oh my God. Are you telling me? Is he gonna do it? Oh my God! Killing a super heavyweight wrestler with a power slam! Oh boy. Oh boy. Don't tell me, is he really gonna do it? That is gonna be a scary, risky way for his health to get a super heavy lifting, and he got him! Unbelievable, too! It's over! Can you believe that? What a Lobo! Beat Bowser with a Nightfall Powerbomb! He managed to carry the super heavyweight wrestler with a vicious powerbomb! Of a Nightfall Powerbomb! I have never seen this super heavyweight! I hope that'll please Kevin Nash after this scary freaking accident. Good old history memories. Here's a classic power slam, and here's a big one. Look how big Bowser is, look how big that Wild Lobo carried that giant King Koopa and does a Nightfall Powerbomb. What a win for Wild Lobo. And of course, he just wanted to get support. He wants to be a lone wolf. He is a darkness will live alone from his head. Ladies and gentlemen, we gotta take a quick commercial break here on the Super Smash Bros. Super Show Road to G1 Climax Stage 1 here in Jacksonville, Florida. It's the night that people will forgive this dangerous lone wolf of all wrestling, Wild Lobo.
We all have moments. Moments where we surpass our own expectations. Sometimes these moments are small. And sometimes they're larger than life. Because there's something great in all of us. Something that connects us. That inspires us. It's why when we fall, we get up again. It's why we give back. And we don't give up. It's what makes all of us, in our own way, heroes. For the hero in all of us.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the UCCW Super Smash Brothers Super Show Road to G1 Climax live in Jacksonville, Florida. And we hope we can have a big announcement for our final stage to determine our first ever G1 Climax winner to see who would get a title shot at Night of Champions 2 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, we're kicking things off in this one, Hitman versus Wario, along with Waluigi, and it starts right now. This could be a tough contest for Wario Brothers, because they have this one, the dangerous gang leader from Chicago, and it's Hitman. He used to form a gang member of the Doom World Orders back in the good old classic times of UCCW, when they formed a Doom World Order with Killer Jason and Destructor. And he used to be a great dangerous gang in New Japan. They won a tag team title there, and Destructor won the heavyweight title in New Japan. Now Hitman is on the road to G1 Climax action. He's on the board. He won his first G1 Climax match after he defeated Justin Jericho with a crazy help by Predator. Let's see, can Hitman focus on this one? Because this time, Wario got his buddy in crime, which is Waluigi. The current tag team champions in Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix. And now, here they come. Here comes a new dangerous stable here in the War of the Universe. Wario wearing, and they are the tag team champions in Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix. They shockingly beat the Super Mario Bros. X and finally captured the prize possession in tag team division in UCCW. The Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix World Tag Team Champions. After a long hard work since the classic days of UCCW back in first season, they finally got the prize. How long will they keep their tag team champions along with Waluigi, JBL, and Serotinienko? What a big move for Wario Brothers, but the embarrassing thing is, they're playing getting their ass kicked in the G1 Climax. Waluigi is trying his best to help his buddy Wario. His first loss was The Rock. Then the second one was Stone Cold Steve Austin. That was a hell of a main event. Let's see, can Wario focus on this contest in this third one? And this one's against Hitman, who is a big-time wrestler who formed a Doom World Orders. Look at Wario's. Let's see if he has confidence on this one. Here we go, 30 minutes are on the clock. Wario Brothers, on to Hitman. Oh, vicious headbutt by Hitman. Waluigi, look at him stare down against Hitman. Can he be dangerous with a look than Hitman? Nice scoop slam by Hitman. Hitman. Look out! No sellout by Wario. That's freaking hilarious. Now Hitman. Throws him in the turnbuckle. Oh! Body splash onto Wario. Oh, Waluigi. Uh-oh. Waluigi. Uh-oh, watch out! Oh! Good move by Waluigi. Now Wario's back on top. Now he's beating the crap out of Hitman. Waluigi escapes it good. He's teasing the fans here in Jacksonville as Wario puts a scoop slam onto Hitman. What's a scoop slam city? Oh! Big move by Hitman. Hitman. Got him onto the ropes. Hitman. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Wow, that's six. I wonder if I could count this in Japan. Oh, Luigi's ticked off after that embarrassing chop by a hitman. Wario. Distraction. Wario got him. Oh! Neckbreaker. I'm going to call this a distraction. It's more like a counter with a sucker punch. Wario. Knee in the gut by... Why knee in the gut on hitman? Excuse me. Sorry about that. Hitman continues to stomp on Wario. Hitman picks up Wario. Hitman. Here it comes. Oh! Sidewalk slam onto Wario! That was good. Here's a pin. Referee's too slow, but he kicks out by one by Wario. Now Hitman back in action. Now what does he have in mind? Oh boy. He's going to choke him again? Oh, he is! Waluigi's not happy about this. Uh-oh. Oh, he got him. Oh, punch him. Uh-oh. Hitman's giving him a warning to stay off his track. And it gives him a big sucker punch onto Waluigi. And Wario distracts him with a clothesline. Here comes Wario. He's not happy about this. The current tag team champions here in Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix. And now Wario. Punch him in the head. He has a tattoo where there's a target in his head. You know how dangerous targeting leader he is. I wonder what leader he is right now, because he has no gang. Oh, wow, Luigi trying to strike Hitman! Bulldog onto Hitman! Oh, they like to play dirty on him. But he has no one to support him. I wonder if Destructor is. Because he used to be buddies with him. But as a dual moral order. Could have Jason left. He's gone back to UK. I guess he's done with wrestling for now. And now, Hitman. Oh, this just kicked in the back onto Wario. Hitman picks up Wario. Irish whip. Nice move by Hitman. Hitman starts with a taunt. Waluigi's gonna try some way to stop him. And there he is in the different spots. Trying to distract him. You see how he's trying to distract Hitman? But look at Hitman! Military press slam! Look at Hitman taunts. Wario's out of the ring. He's gonna have a timeout break with Waluigi. Remember, there's a count of rules. The referee's on the one. And then Wario's trying to pick on the referee for some reason. That was weird. Remember, they're dirty players. The dirtiest tag teams in UCCW. Are they more dirtier than the Largos? It's gonna be tough to debate. Oh, come on, Waluigi! Come on! Why are you doing this to my announce table? I saw that! Oh, no duty to Wario. Yeah, I was mad that Waluigi was messing with my announce table. I thought Waluigi would be like, oh, did I hit your announce table? Screw you, it's my Waluigi time! Look at Waluigi's trying to cheat! It's Waluigi time! He's trying to strike Hitman! Oh, look at Hitman! Choking the hell on the knee onto his neck of Wario. Wario left the ring again. And Hitman, oh, he's pissed off. Wario's trying to run away. Try to escape from Hitman. Watch out! Oh! Gets bumped to his fat. Get hit by a Lardo. He can't run that much because he's fat. I just said that from Scott Steiner court. He's fat! Not that good at pronouncing how the way that Scott Steiner used to say he's fat. He said that when he screams. Not that very good at pronouncing it. No, I meant to say it. I'm not that good at pronouncing... Never mind. Impersonation of Scott Steiner. That's what I meant to say. Anyways. Hitman back into the ring. And apparently he's going back into the ring. He's trying to reset the time from the referee. I guess he wants to destroy him from the announce table. So, I really want to do this. Really? Wario is going to get dazed to hell. Oh! God! Oh! He's gonna have a horrible time in his dizzy life. He's fat, I know. Oh boy. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh! There goes my announce table! Pulverized! By Hitman! Now, Hitman! Well, he knew he's gonna get up. Referee's on the set, man. Where the heck is Waluigi? Where is he? Is this supposed to be Waluigi time, or is it time over? He's gonna come back, I can tell, because it's Waluigi again. It's never gonna stop. Hey, I think he's on a different screen, because the camera's focusing. Oh, there he is! It's Waluigi time! Hit him right time, I just can't tell. It's hilarious. Now, Hitman! Uh-oh! Oh, Hitman! There he comes! Hitbreaker! That's it! But Waluigi time! He's gonna distract the referee! He knows Waluigi time! And gets clobbered by Hitman! Uh-oh, Wario. Was he out of mind? Uh-oh. Referee's continuing talking to the referee. Hey! He has a chair! He has a chair! Oh, come on now! Damn it, ref! He has a chair! What's he gonna do? He's standing in a chair. Oh yeah, referee, pick that chair out and threw it away. Thank you. At least referee knows the best way in wrestling. But the stupidest thing about the referee we had in UCW, they're slow. We need to train them better to go fast. Now Hitman is ready to do something big as Waluigi's right behind him. He's about to do Waluigi time on Hitman. Oh! That's a boot! Big boot by Hitman! He's about to finish him, but watch out for Waluigi! Uh-oh! He's about to do it, and... Hitbreaker again! There it is! No! Waluigi time again! Another distraction! He's struggling to throw him off, but no! Hitman gets distracted! Wario got him! Gutbuster onto Hitman! Clothesline onto Hitman! Wario! Trying to cheat away, but no! Hitman's not gonna let him do it! He's giving him a clobber onto Wario and took him down! Hitman! Excuse me. Let's see, Hitman can try again. Here he goes. He's about to bring a beating onto Wario. And got him! Hitman! Impact with the spear! Devastation of the big force of the spear by Hitman. Hitman! Look at that strength with a military press slam! And now he's going to finish him off! Could this be a hit breaker? He got him! He's going to do it, and... Oh no, he's going to do the hit slam! Hit slam! And now Waluigi time is over! Wario is still onto the steel steps! Crash and burn! Here we go! 1, 2, and that's it! Hitman is on the board! That was freaking amazing by Hitman! Screw Waluigi time, it's Hitman time! Wow! Here's a hit breaker, but he didn't make it pin because of Waluigi. Yeah, here's that Waluigi distraction, it's Waluigi time. And here's that signature move, the military press slam onto Wario, and then he finished him off with a hit slam, and then he chokes down Waluigi with a running STO crash and burn onto the steel steps. That was freaking insane. I'm surprised how Hitman is turning in this business here in UCCW. I never knew how Hitman goes out like that. Now Hitman's on the board, surprisingly. Well, it makes sense because Hitman used to be the top of the games in XCW back in the good old times. Like how my good old friend Darian Rouse says, he's an XCW classic. XCW icon, if you like to call him that. This is pretty interesting so far. We're getting good heated for these matches here in a G1 Climax. Great matches, great wrestling maneuvers, and a great shocking moments in a G1 Climax. Who will be in the top? Who will be the first ever G1 Climax winner in the history of UCCW throughout the video game wrestling universe is about to witness? Here comes this G1 Climax contest. Brother versus Mr. Capital. Alright, here comes this contest. Predator, one of the most successful bounty hunters of all the galaxy. One of the best icons in a sci-fi movie. Here comes Predator. The fishes, alien bounty hunter in all the galaxy. Predator is a former world heavyweight champion of video game wrestling Grand Prix after he won back in Elimination Series after he defeated Dominic. It's good to see Dominic facing Predator again. Man, that was a great hell of a match that was in the main event. Death spear in the mid-air, that was priceless. That was embarrassing for Predator's first loss. But let's see, can he regain his focus? Well, he's on losing streak, which is horrible to see his picture. With the look of his face, he lost to Seth Rollins because of Justin Jericho, and now he lost to Dominator. He has no points. The biggest question is, can he try to get back in the board in the G1 Climax tournament? Let's see. Because here comes Predator. He's ready to find a way to get his points back. It could be easy for him, but good luck. Because here comes this wrestler. He was a former Intercontinental Champion, but he lost to Fulgore back in Killer Instinct in Chicago. And that match wasn't in the steel cage. From Seattle, Washington. He is a fan of the Seattle Seahawks. And it's embarrassing to see his Seahawks lost to the freaking Patriots. It's time to support your troops. Support your military family and to the country. It's Mr. Capital time. He's trying to bring the punishment to the enemy. That'll be a nice catchphrase. Who knows? Because Mr. Capital, former Intercontinental Champion UCCW in Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix, they take on the bounty hunter. That's going to be interesting here in Jacksonville, Florida. But watch out, because Predator has his backup, Black Lady. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. The match is underway between Predator and Mr. Capital. Here we go. Mr. Capital from Seattle, Washington, and Predator from the galaxy far, far away. And no. Wait, he's going to be Star Wars? I would imagine he'd be on Star Wars, which he did. Which he faced Boba Fett back in Rage in the Cage. I would be surprised if he wasn't a crossover. That would be crazy. Just like how they did with Aliens vs. Predators. No, Aliens vs. Predator. I think Aliens vs. Predators because there's more than one Predator. That movie was good until Requiem wasn't that good. Look at Mr. Capital! Look, he's bringing impact onto Predator! Mr. Capital, super powerful strength from this military mind of this wrestler. Look at two wrestlers who are representing their military country. Mr. Capital and Curtis Sanchez, they're both known to be supportive to their country. And Curtis is a fan of St. Louis Rams, while Mr. Capital is a fan of the Seattle Seahawks. I know how they feel. When the Rams beat the Seahawks and the Broncos. Pretty good season so far from the Rams. A good move for Rams getting rid of Sam Bradford after he's having a sad season with so much injury he had. Anyways, Predator, Blackley on the side. Oh, still on the ropes. Predator still on the hang on the ropes. Tooks down Mr. Capital. Watch out! Oh! Big collision. Oh! Onto his nuts. That's ouch. That's gonna be a one and kick out. Man, painful to the balls. He even does that. Oh! Tilt the wall slam by Predator. Look at Predator taunts. Predator. On his feet. Got Mr. Capital. Oh, look at that strength. Great counter by Mr. Capital. Big chop onto Predator. Predator's in trouble right now. Mr. Capital. Scoop slam onto the apron right in front of the Black Lady. That's gonna tick her off. Stomped him in the nuts. There you go. Just like how you, after what Predator punched him in the balls. I haven't said that for a long time. Balls. That's one of the funniest catchphrases I say. Oh, big strength by Mr. Capital going for the pin right in front of Black Lady and just only getting one. It's gonna take more than that to take that straight against that alien monster. or a bloody bounty hunter. And now Mr. Capital starts to taunt, waiting for Predator to get up, and he did. Irish whip by Mr. Capital. Oh, wow! Big knee onto Predator. That was amazing by Mr. Capital. Crazy knee running onto Predator. And look at that strength! Amazing! Let's see, can he do it? Referee is on the rush as he can too, and no! Not gonna do it. Likely on the ringside. Referee is giving her a warning while Mr. Capital got Predator onto the ropes and does a suplex. And Black Lady is getting a warning from the referee, and Mr. Capital is about to do a finisher. He's about to do a Capital collision. No, counter by Predator. Predator, got him. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. Oh, my God. Oh, vicious pile driver. That's one of his signature moves, but he's not done yet. And he's going to get a timeout break with the Black Lady. What the heck are they doing? But he didn't know that Mr. Capital is already up and took him down. And Black Lady safely left the apron. And he's doing a Booker T style. Yeah, isn't it funny? Like how you see how you post a picture of Booker T with Predator? Yeah, it's crazy. Five-time WCW champion, being a former World Heavyweight Champion Video Game Wrestling Grand Prix Predator. This is the craziest picture ever. Uh-oh, Mr. Capital's ticked off. He's all fired up. He's all fired up. There he goes. Bringing the strength and giving a torturing of Predator. Oh, Black Lady's ticked off. Hey, don't even think about messing with the announce table. And here he goes. Mr. Capital. He's about to... Oh, Black Lady! What the hell? Just distract him. He just attacked Mr. Capital. Balls! And even worse, God! And everybody's giving her a warning. Not even giving Predator a DQ after what Black Lady did to him. Big chop by Predator. Don't even think about doing an announce table again. I don't care. I'm just gonna do it. Oh! DDT onto Mr. Capital. Holy smokes. I'm glad she is not touching my announce table. Oh! There's that pile driver for a second time! I'm guessing this is gonna be over, folks. Doing a Booker T! Oh boy. I wonder how people are going to think about Booker T and Predator. Oh no. Here comes the finishing move. That could be history making, folks. Predacizer! That's it. That could be it. That's it. One, two, and that's it. That is your history making. Predator is finally back on the board. 5 minutes and 59 seconds overall. Predator wins. Gets 2 points. After that predecessor on Mr. Capital. Nice try from Mr. Capital. Here's that pile job that he did on Mr. Capital twice. And then the ending, finished him off with the deadliest clothesline he had ever performed in wrestling. Predecessor. Also known as a clothesline. There's that 3 count. As we all know, that's it. There's your winner. Predator is on the tough break, but he's finally getting 2 points. And he's going to try his best to get back on the board. Will he do it? After his embarrassing loss to Seth Rollins and Dominator, but he won against Mr. Capital. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned for part two for UCCW Super Smash Bros. Super Show Road to G1 Climax, Stage 1, live in Jacksonville, Florida.